Strawweight World Championship!
The Strawweight Championship of the World. Inside the sold-out, jam-packed Mall of Asia Arena in Manila, the Philippines. Challenger Joshua Pacio from Baguio City. The champion, Yosuke Tsuruta. This one brought to you by Wholesome Solido. High up on the balls of his feet early, the champion, Tsuruta. A wushu striking of Joshua Pacio. Pacio, the former world champion. Tsuruta, the one world champion, and Shuto world champion. Fake there from Tsuruta. Switching stance between Wilcox and Southpaw here.
That's the low leg kicks of Joshua Pacio. He says he wants to attack that lower part of the leg and start kicking the calf of Tsuruta.
Now Mitch, Tsuruta isn't using that awkward, strange 90 degree angle guard we saw him use last time. Oh, throwing it back kick! Smack back in the guts from Joshua Pacio.
Nice spinning back kick from Joshua Pacio. You're right, Michael, he's not utilizing that guard, but again, that's more of the mind games coming from the ninja. Doesn't want to utilize that guard, but I do think we'll see it later on in this matchup.
Overhand right from Tsuruta, outside leg kick, overhand right again there from Tsuruta. Chance went up for Let's Go Pacio here in Manila.
Nice duck under to a double leg from Tsuruta as he ends up in half guard.
Pacio, see the instructions from Mark Sanjao in the corner here from Team Legai. Half guard position for the champion. Controlling the posture here though, Pacio, not allowing Tsuruta to posture up and work that vicious ground and pound that he has. Patience here from Pacio, a stalemate move.
See, Saruka's got his head wrapped around, or his arm, his left arm wrapped around the neck there. He can try to get past his half guard position of Joshua Pacio. There's a choke he's got as long as Joshua Pacio holds the head in that position.
Look for finish.
Under 3 minutes remaining. First round set for five for the strawweight world title. Referee Kim Chung right on top of the action. If Pacio can win the title back, the Mall of Asia Arena will melt down. To their feet, inside leg kick here from the champion, Tsuruta. Oh, the high kick! Tried for the headache maker, did Joshua Pacio.
Joshua Pacio's going headhunting early. He's already tried to go upstairs a couple of times now.
Big hello to all our fans watching on ABS-CBN Sports in Action here in the Philippines, on Abima TV in Japan. Skips forward the champion, doesn't commit though. There's a left hand from Tsuruta. Definitely inside the Mall of Asia Arena when they chant Pacio's name. All of Team Legai's former champions are here. Flying Bellignon, Eustaquio. Also in attendance, circle side, the world's heavyweight champion, Philippine star Brandon Vera. So many luminaries have turned out in force for this night of nights in Filipino martial arts. The balls of his feet again here, Tsuruta. Inside leg kick from the champion. Still Mitch, a filling out process from both of these two competitors.
You know, they're still kind of just, you know, there's not a lot of...
Big kibosh from Tsuruta, and Pacio on the canvas, on his back now.
That's the end of the feeling out process, I assume.
Tsuruta's got some confidence flowing now. He tries to mount it.
Pacio's got to keep him tight to get his grip back about it. This is where Tsuruta's got to create a little bit of space. I'd like to see him frame off the head and start pushing the head down. There he goes. Good scramble by Joshua.
Pacio back to his feet. The crowd appreciates that. Let's see the wushu starting now with Pacio. And he beat the champion to the strikes.
Well, the first match happened about 13 weeks ago, so that's not a lot of time to make a lot of improvement. But what you can do is you can get in better shape and also figure out your game plan. Whoever can implement their game plan to the perfection. perfection tonight is going to be the one who walks away with that belt.
Looping punches from Pacio. 20 seconds remains. Low check there from Saruta. And Saruta taunting in the mind games from the Japanese world champion.
Taunting with the right hand there. Is that what he's doing?
Trying to get inside the head of Pacio. Pacio jumping roundhouse kick off the lead leg. But Saruta plants him like a tree earlier on with that big punch.
Joshua had some early success here as he spins and goes right to the body with a beautifully timed, but then Saruta was able to answer right back with that right hand. Boom, right on the button, puts Pacio down. And then he was able to get on top and do a little bit of ground and pound. Joshua did a good job though of keeping Saruta nice and tight, getting his, clearing his head, and then getting right back into the match. Very interesting first round. Or should I say sixth round?
Joshua Pacio looking to reclaim the title that the man left of screen took from him. Instructions from Mark Sanjiao and Edward Falayang in the corner of Pacio.
Oh no.
Sold out inside the mighty Mall of Asia Arena in Manila, the Philippines, for one championship Roots of Honor.
Ready.
Turned out in their thousands for this one, the Strawweight World title. Will it be a Filipino victory? Good two-punch combination off the bell there for Pacio. Switching stance, Saruta. AEG veteran. Has all the tricks in the book, and then some that aren't even written in the book. Pacio. Looks to get airborne with that knee, but didn't commit to it, didn't have the distancing.
That's good.
Saruta inside leg kick. High kick from Pacio. He's enjoying that high right roundhouse tonight. Hasn't really found success with it, though.
He was expecting to throw that roundhouse kick off of the awkward guard shown by Saruta, and Saruta hasn't shown him that guard yet. Again, more of that veteran mind game move as Pacio.
Getting back fist from Saruta, a counter punch from Pacio, accidentally struck the back of the head. Apologies there, good sportsmanship. The media attention on this bout, on this entire card, has been crazy. Our media conference at City of Dreams earlier on in the week was a record attendance, some 500 plus media members, the biggest in history. All over the news and Team Lakai. Athletes appearing on CNN Philippines earlier this week. Outside leg kick there from Saruta. Manila really is a hotbed for one championship. Indeed, this entire combat crazy nation love one championship, especially when it comes to town. It was in Saruta's town a couple of weeks ago in Tokyo. Falayang saw the title lost against Shinya Aoki, who put him to sleep in the first round. Meaning that all of Team Lakai's titles were gone. It's now the responsibility of Pacio to win one back for the men from Baguio City.
Good movement shown by Saruta, but as soon as Saruta stopped and got a stationary stance, that's when Pacio spun and landed another spinning back kick. I think this movement's kind of got Joshua Pacio a little bit confused here in the second as he marches forward and throws a big right hand there from Saruta.
Haven't really seen Pacio open up with his wushu, with the striking, the combinations. Has had some acrobatics, turning back kicks and jumping roundhouse kicks. Nothing that's landed effective telling blows on Saruta so far. Another agonizingly close rear leg roundhouse kick. Left hand followed by a right there by Saruta.
Saruta closes that distance incredibly fast with that lightning fast footwork, how he's in and out of there. And Pacio seems to have a hard time getting into the rhythm.
Lots of angles being cut here from Saruta.
I like that strategy employed by Cerruti, not to stay still as he ducks under a big head kick there.
Certainly, Pacio is going for that head kick time and time again. And there's the first show of that strange forearm guard that Cerruti did last time that confounded Pacio. Oh, overhand right from Cerruti, tried for the counter.
Pacio said he didn't want to spin as much as he did in the first time, because you can start to see that Cerruti started to time that, started to step to the outside right as Pacio was spinning. And that's the same mistake that Foliang made with Nguyen. Nguyen saw it coming over and over again, and he started to step to the side. And then what happened? Boom, a big overhand right that caught Foliang mid-spin. Pacio's got to be careful with this spinning.
Inside leg kick there from Cerruti. Mitch went high on the thigh, but do you think that both men are holding back a little here? We haven't really seen them put the foot down to the gas.
Well, in the second round, they're still, you know, they're still trying to get a bearing on each other. So I don't think Pacio expected Cerruti to A, come out in this stance, B, this mobile, and I think the Cerruti is a little bit surprised at the inactivity coming back from Pacio, because Pacio said he did not want to wait, he did not want to hesitate. Last 10 seconds.
Another break off there from Cerruti. Final few seconds of this round. High kick from Pacio. Two rounds down, set for five. Strawweight world title on the line. Cerruti versus Pacio from inside the Mall of Asia Arena in Manila.
Second round was more of a feeling out process than the first round. We got to see that big right hand from Cerruti in the first and a couple of spinning back kicks throughout the course of this match so far coming from Pacio. But what kind of changes are we going to make? I'd like to see Pacio start attacking that lower leg, slow down the movement of Cerruti, just start hammering on that calf, which is something he said he wanted to do. Start putting the punches in the face of Cerruti. I like how Cerruti in the first round was mixing things in with the takedowns. I'd like to see him throw hands, close that distance, and start at least giving Pacio something else to think about besides just the striking. Get into his head a little bit more. Throw those takedowns in.
Come here.
Third round of five. Wherever you're watching, in 140 countries around the world, we hope you're enjoying it. That's one championship, Roots of Honor.
Ready.
Kevin Chang had the same concern we did, and he urged the guys to show a little bit more activity in the third round.
Jab from Cerruti. Roundhouse kick from Pacio, just tucked under the left arm. Thrust out the jab with the Filipino. Body shot, stuck it well, belly button through the back.
Pacio likes that technique. He likes to go high with the roundhouse and then follow it up with a spinning back kick. He was able to drop Roy Deliguez back in 2017 in the second round with a beautiful spinning back fist off of that roundhouse kick.
Let's see if Pacio can work those wushu kicking skills of his. Lots of movement here from Yasuke Cerruti. Cerruti, the current world champion. Pacio, the former world champion. And right there from Pacio.
Cerruti is still the owner of the biggest punch so far in this match with that big overhand right that happened in the first. Nice leg kick there by Pacio.
Two punch combination from Pacio. Backs off Cerruti.
You can start to see the superficial damage on the lower lead leg of Pacio. It's starting to welt up there from that one kick. They're starting to mixing things in with the takedowns. Skip the takedown. Now he's trying to pass the guard. Nice elevation there from Pacio to get back to his feet.
The crowd momentarily thought that Pacio had a choke locked onto the champion.
But I like the strategy from Cerruti. Mix in the takedowns. Get Pacio thinking about that. At least start fearing it so he doesn't start to throw, like, this is how he doesn't get so comfortable with the stand up.
Pacio fainting. So too, Cerruti. Razor thin, this world title matchup at the moment. Angles again from Cerruti, the cagey one. Pacio tried to counter. Inside leg from Cerruti. jab, no right hand for company though. Turning back in, looking for the liver of Saruta. It's a Team Lakai specialty. The impact, the liver.
Final warning.
Very large target. Just to the right of the stomach there. And the impact of Vegas North that closed down the entire body. They say one of the most painful ways, if not the most painful way to get knocked out, is with a liver strike. Particularly a liver punch where you're driving the knuckles up in between the 9th and 10th ribs. But the turning back into the liver will do just as well. Overhand right, the cranium cracker there from Pacio. Just needed a little bit more musty behind it. Outside leg kick. Now Pacio starting to land some heavier strikes, Dragon.
He is, he's starting to put together those kicks with a little bit more of the punches as well. He's throwing combinations, he's getting a little more comfortable.
Turning spinning though. In.
That time Saruta was able to step to the side of it. He's starting to see it coming. Because the problem is when he steps to the side, he's able to avoid it. But when he goes back, he tries to ride the wave of that kick to it to kind of take away some of the pressure from it. I don't think it's hurting him so much, but it's scoring in the mind of the judges. And also the score sheets.
1:15 remains. Don't forget we are scoring an overall bout, not round by round, under these one championship global rule sets. High kick again from Pacio. Saruta leans back in evasion. Left hook from the champion.
In the third round.
Again, bound up and spun on Saruta. Did you expect a little bit more action from Saruta?
I did, especially in this third round. He started the first round off very effectively, and then he's kind of gotten slowed down as the matches went on. But Pacio is not really doing as much as I thought he would do either. He's landed a few beautiful side kicks, and that's really been the most significant strike of this round. I do like the takedown of Saruta beginning.
Overhand right there from Pacio. Inside leg goes Saruta. Final second to the third of five. Two more rounds to go here in Manila for the one strawweight world title.
Man, these guys have been in the ring, the circle, for 40 minutes together. They have a really good read on what to expect. And so they know each other very, very well. So don't get caught too much in this slow action. But we're seeing a lot of very technical details starting to inch forward, especially now that we hit the championship rounds again. This is round, essentially, this is going to be round 9 between these two. I'd like to see Pacio do more of it. Be more active. Start throwing those hands. Start putting the pressure on Saruta. Back him up. I want to see Saruta mix in more takedowns. Start throwing a little more heat with the punches, backing Pacio up and then shooting him for those takedowns. Very close match so far.
You see the ice being applied there by former world champion Edward Falaya. 130 martial arts world champions on the one championship roster. Two of them in the circle at the moment. Let's see if we have some more pepper, some more get up and go here. This is Saruta, body punches here from Pacio. Saruta turns him around against the fence and drives the corking knees into the thighs. Pacio turns the champion.
Saruta placing the hand there on the knee to stop any retaliation from the knees from Pacio.
Body shot from Pacio, got in quick, got out even quicker. High kick from Saruta. Pacio to stab himself in center circle here. Cross out the jab. Saruta does have some damage under the right eye, courtesy of that lead hand of Pacio. Some reddening on the lead thigh and shin calf area of Pacio, courtesy of the leg kicks from the champion. There's another one.
Yeah.
Fourth round of five. Jab two from Pacio. Again, Mitch gets in quick and scores, gets out.
This is the Pacio we expected to see. We want to see those fast blitzes, bop, bop, in and out. So we're just kind of getting hypnotized by it. Now he's starting to come forward.
Mitch, if the match was stopped right now, who would you have ahead?
And after the first round with the knockdown, beautiful stiff kick there from Saruta. Saruta landed on Saruta. That big first round knockdown, but now I'm starting to see in the second, third round, Pacio starting to inch forward. I think he's more aggressive. I think his striking superiority is there.
And a hand-right counter from Pacio. After a nice left hook. Saruta, under 3 minutes remains. Penultimate round of action here. Certainly seeing some heavier artillery being launched now by both of these world champions.
In the first match, we did not see Saruta do a kickboxing match with Joshua Pacio. He was going for takedowns. He was mixing things up. He was inside the clinch, wearing on Pacio. Now all he's doing now is just striking with him in the last couple rounds. But to answer your question, if the match was stopped right now, I might give a slight edge to the Team Lakai athlete.
Come on! Freaking Irene! Manila goes into a meltdown!
Wow! What a head kick! Catches Saruta! And drops the champion! Strawweight world champion, the passion getting Team Lakai back into the championship realm.
He planted him like a tree. Yusuke Saruta still on the astral plane. Joshua Pacio is the new champion of the world. They're going crazy here in Manila.
Wow, are we gonna see a rubber match or is that all she wrote? What a shot! Look at this head kick. I think that reminds me of the Edward Kelly against Bob Mouth, like knee slash head kick, just starching. Beautiful head kick, the walk off KO. For the passion, Joshua Pacio. Let's go talk to the new champion.
Amazing scenes here in Manila. My word, a highlight reel KO. Here's Dom Lack.
To present the belt for this match, we have CEO and President Philippines of Holcim, Mr. John Stowe. And now, ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Kent Chang, has called a stop to this contest after 2 minutes and 43 seconds in the fourth round for your winner by way of knockout! And new one strawweight world champion, Joshua!
Joshua Pacio is once again a world champion. Team Lakai once again has a world title belt in its possession.
Hey guys, it's Misha Tate. If you want to see more awesome ONE Championship content, make sure you click that subscribe button. Click it so you don't miss it.